Hello, good morning students. Today we will start with the question number 3 of exercise 7.1. Okay, read the question. Determine if the points 1, 5, 2, 3, minus 2, minus 11 are collinear. In this way question getting, you should give the name, you should name the points. That means I given the name of the points as ABC, A15, P23 and C minus 2 minus 11. So first of all we will write the distance formula. If distance formula corresponding formulas not writing, half mark will deduct. Therefore the distance formula is root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. And now you are taking AB, then the coordinates of B you take as x2 y2 and coordinates of A you take as x1 y1. Okay, so here you see 2 minus 1 the whole square plus 3 minus 5 the whole square. Okay, that is equal to 1 square plus minus 2 the whole square, that is 1 plus 4, that is equal to root 5. So you got the value of AB as root 5. Now we will find out the value of BC. See here, BC how much getting? So BC, this is x2 y2 and this is x1 y1. So x2 minus 2, middle sign is always minus only will come, minus. And x1 is 2. So minus 2 minus 2 the whole square plus minus 11 minus the value of y1 is 3. Minus 11 minus 3 the whole square. Okay. Now see. So minus 4 the whole square plus minus 14 the whole square got. So minus 4 the whole square is 16, minus 14 the whole square is 196. While adding you are getting it is 212. That we can write as BC is equal to root of 4 is 2. So 2 root 53. Now similarly you find out the value of AC. AC also I written over here. You knowing now formula how applying. Okay. Minus 2 minus 1 the whole square plus minus 11 minus 5 the whole square. So minus 3 the whole square plus minus 16 the whole square. Minus 3 the whole square is 9 plus 16 the whole square is 256. Adding you are getting as 265. Now you got the value of AB, BC and AC. The value of AB you got as root 5. The value of BC you got as 2 root 53. The value of AC you got as root of 265. Now very clearly you can say any two line segments adding never we are getting the third one. You add AB and BC add you will get this one. No. BC and AC add you will not get AB. So any two line segments if your length of the line segments adding we are not getting the third one. Therefore what I written here AB plus BC not equal to AC. AC plus BC not equal to AB. And AC plus AB also not equal to BC. Okay. Therefore, what you can say? Therefore, we can say the points are not collinear. The points are not collinear. That only I written here. Okay. Now, question number 4 I given as homework for you. Okay, do by yourself. And question number 5, listen. Questions you see from the textbook. Okay. All of you take your textbook and see from the textbook. All of you see the textbook. Question number 5, take it and textbook also open and see. So you want to find out here in the I will read the question. Four friends are seated at the points A, B, C, D as shown in the figure 7.8. I told you open your textbook. Okay. And Champa and Chameli walk into the class and after observing for a few minutes, Champa asked Chameli that don't you think A, B, C, D is a square? And Chameli disagrees. And Champa said it may be square and Chameli disagreeing. So you want to say that using distance formula which find which of them is correct. Who is correct? Champa said correct or Chameli said correct. You want to find out by using distance formula. First of all what you will do? You want to find out the coordinates of ABCD. ABCD coordinates you find out. See the diagram. Diagram C. You can see that the point A. So column wise horizontal written no? Horizontal written it is x axis, vertical drawn it is y axis. Horizontal line you see, from the point A you draw, see the perpendicular where touching, the foot you see 3. Therefore, x coordinate is 3 and perpendicular to y axis you see y coordinate is 4. Therefore, the coordinates of A is 3, 4. All of you see the textbook, then only you will get. And next one is, we can see the coordinates of B. B's footwear touching at the point 6. Therefore, to the y axis we are touching 7. Therefore, the coordinates of B is 6, 7. And similarly, find out the coordinates of C. From C, foot of the C touching where on the x axis? At the point 9. And to the perpendicular to y, where touching? At the point 4. Therefore, the coordinates of C is 9, 4. Similarly, see the coordinates of D. Foot of the perpendicular from the point D to the x axis C, at the point 6 touching, to y axis where touching? At the point 1. Therefore, D 6, 1. So, in this way, from the diagram, we have to write all the coordinates. Coordinates are not given. You have to write from the textbook. Okay, students, got? Now, what we will do? We will write the distance formula. Distance formula written as usual. And find out AB. AB find out. A is 3, 4. And B is 6, 7. Therefore, start 6 minus 3, the whole square plus 7 minus 4, the whole square. Where I am pointing, there you see. So, 6 minus 3, how much coming? 3. 3, the whole square. 7 minus 3, 7 minus 4, how much coming? 7 minus 4 is plus 3 only. So, I written here minus 3. So, you correct as plus 3. Okay. So, silly, small problems may be there. That calculation only, no, you can correct by yourself. While writing time, small mistakes coming. So, 6 minus 3, the whole square is 3. 3 square. 7 minus 4, how much coming? Plus 3, the whole square. So, 3 the whole square is 9. And my again, plus 3 the whole square is 9. So, 9 plus 9, how much came? Root 18. This root 18, you can split. I written here. Root 18, you can split over here in this way. Root of 2 into 9. Root of 2 into 9, how much coming? 3 root 2. Root of 9, 3 coming. So, 3 root 2. So, you got the value of AB, how much? 3 root 2 got. Okay. Same way, you find out BC. See here. B and C everywhere. I didn't return the points. So, direct you write. BC how much coming? Coordinates of B and C take. Coordinates of B how much coming? A, BC. Okay. Coordinates of C take a 9 minus 6 the whole square plus. And 4 minus 7 the whole square. See the coordinates of B and C. B. See here. 9 minus 6 the whole square plus 4 minus 7 the whole square. Okay. So, 9 minus 6, how much? 3. And 4 minus 7, how much coming? Minus 3, the whole square. So, 9 plus 9, again root 18. So, we can write it as 3 root 2. The value of BC, how much got? 3 root 2. It is no need to explain more and more, only applications. And now CD. CD also same way. Coordinates of C and D take. What's the coordinates of C and D? 9, C and D, CD. So, 6 minus 9 the whole square minus plus 1 minus 4 the whole square. 6 minus 9 means minus 3 the whole square. 1 minus 4 means minus 3 the whole square. Again there also 9 plus 9 root 18 coming. That is you are getting the value as 3 root 2. Okay. AB got, BC got, CD got. And now we are going to find out the last one, AD. Last AD, C. Coordinates of A and take, D and take a. Coordinates of A is 3, 4 and coordinates of D is 6, 1. Take. Calculate yourself. AD. 6 minus 3 the whole square plus 1 minus 4 the whole square. That is equal to 3 the whole square plus minus 3 the whole square. Here also again you are getting which value? 3 root 2. So, all the four sides you got equal. AB, BC, CD and AD all you got as equal. AB, BC, CD, DA all are equal getting. We can say that it is a square or rhombus. Now you want to find out once more. Diagonal also find out. If diagonal also equal, we can say it is square. If diagonal not equal, we can say it is rhombus. Okay. So, we are going to find out the diagonal now. See here. What is the point I written? AB, BC, CD and DA, all the four sides are equal. Now we can find out the diagonal. For diagonals, which are they? AC and BD are the diagonals. C, A and C points I written here, so write 9 minus 3 whole square plus 4 minus 4 the whole square, that is root of 6 the whole square plus 0 square, that means root of 36, you got it as 6. Similarly, BD find out, BD also coordinates written here. So 6 minus 6 the whole square plus 1 minus 7 the whole square, that is equal to 0 square plus minus 6 the whole square, that is equal to 0 plus 36. Root of 36, how much getting? 6. Okay. So here you got the diagonal also equal. Sides, all the four sides are equal and all the both the diagonals are equal. If all the sides and the diagonals are equal getting, we can say it is a square. Okay, so what you can say? A, B, C, D is a square. So I already given the properties early videos. Okay, if all the four sides are equal and the diagonal also equal, then we can say A, B, C, D is a square. Therefore, who said correct? Chamba is said the correct. Okay, clear? So in this way, we can, this type of several questions are there. So concept is clear, then you can be able to do any sums. Okay, students? Okay, got clear now? So all the four sides you got equal and the diagonals also equal got. Therefore, we can say that ABCD is a square. Therefore, what you can say? Who said correct? Chamba said correct. And next question, question number 6. Three sums are given. Teacher only explained one sum. And second and third homework given. So second and third, if you feel any doubt, ask to me. Okay. So the second, first one we can see. Name the type of the quadrilateral formed, if any, by selecting points and give the reason for your answer. So here A, B, C, D, I given the names as usual. See, any problem? So the points A, B, C, D give, P, Q, R, S give, anything you give. So we given the names as A, B, C and D. Now as usual, what you will find out? You find out A, B, B, C, C, D and D, A find out. Okay. From that you will get an idea. See here, AB I found out. No need to explain again. Same only. A and B taking x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. Okay. Here minus and minus came, so plus 1. 1 plus 1, 2 coming. And here 0 minus minus coming, so plus 2 coming. Okay. So root of 8 got, root of 8 we can write as 4 into 2, that is equal to 2 root 2. Clear? And next one, BC find out same way. BC also do yourself. What is x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. Okay. Minus 1 minus 1 minus 2 gain. And here 2 minus 0 means 2, 2 the whole square. Root of 4 plus 4, root 8, root of 4 into 2, that is 2 root 2. BC also you got as 2 root 2. And same way CD find out, CD also what you got as 2 root 2. And AD find out, AD also you got as 2 root 2. So that what you can say, all the sides are equal got. If all the sides are equal got, now you next procedure what you do, find out the diagonal also. Diagonal find out. Diagonal means AC is the diagonal. So A and C points are given here. Same method you proceed. X2 minus X1 the whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 the whole square. Same way proceed. Here minus 1. Here minus minus came, so plus 1. Okay. So it is 0. And here you are getting plus 4 the whole square. So root of 16. Root of 16 how much coming? 4. And now BD find out. Same procedure do. X2 minus X1 whole square plus 0 minus 0 the whole square. So root of 16 getting. Root of 16 is 4. Here also you got the diagonals are equal. And all the four sides are equal. And the diagonals are equal. Then what you can say? A, B, C, D is a square. Okay. If all the four sides are equal and the diagonals are equal, then what you can say? The given quadrilateral is a square. Okay, and now second and third I told you already, given as homework, do by yourself. Okay, now question number 7. Question number 7, read all of you. Read question number 4. Find the point on the x-axis which is equidistant from 2 minus 5 and minus 2 minus 9. These are different types of questions. So make it clear content. Okay. Find the point on the x-axis. Already I given. Point on the x-axis. If a point is on the x-axis, what will be its coordinates? On the x-axis, its y-coordinate is always 0. On the y-axis, its x-coordinate will be always 0. So find the point on the x-axis. So one point is on the x-axis. That point is equidistant from which points? From this point and this point. Equidistant means equal distance. That is, distance between this point and this point will be equal to distance between this point and this point. Okay, so here I given the name for the points. So the point on the x, I told you its y coordinate will be always 0. So we given a name for that point on the x axis. Are you getting clear? Point on the x axis, what is its format? A point is on the x axis is given, always its format will be px0. P means you can give any name. Okay, but the format this only will come. Ordered pair x0. Because it is on the x-axis. X-axis is there, x-coordinate will exist. Y-coordinate will be always 0. So let Px0 be a point on the x-axis which is at equal distance from the point A and from the point B. The meaning is that distance between P and A, distance between P and B are equal. Equal distance, equidistant, what is the meaning? The distance between these two points and distance between these two points will be always equal. For example, if the distance between P and A, suppose you are taking as 10, then what will be the distance between P and B? That also will be 10. Equidistant word meaning is that. That means this point P is equidistant from A and B. The meaning is that PA and PB are equal. Clear? That only teacher written here. PA is equal to PB. PA is equal to PB, then what about PA square and PB square? They are also equal. Because for example, PA is equal to 10, PB is equal to 10. So 10 square is equal to 10 square. Therefore, PA square is equal to PB square. Here actually I done no direct. If you need, some students how to do PA and PB finding out. And then we are applying this condition, then squaring them. In one sum, I explained that method also for your understanding. Okay, this one I done direct. Here PA square, PA, you knowing PA is equal to root of, distance formula must you have to write anywhere. PA is equal to root of x2 minus x1 the whole square plus y2 minus y1 the whole square. Okay, then PA square coming, what will happen? Square root is not necessary. Square root no need to write. For example, PA is equal to root of 5. Then PA square what will be? 5. Okay, root will not come. Okay, so that I didn't written here root. Because what we are taking? PA square we are taking here. PA is equal to root of. And PA square taking, what will happen? Root will cancel. Okay, are you got clear this point? Why I written here this way? So I written PA square here and here PB square written. That is why I didn't mention the root here. Root will not come. Clear? Okay, now see. We can see P. Where is P? P is x0. And what is A? 2 minus 5. See here. This is x2, y2 take. This is x1, y1 take. Anyway, taking no problems. Huh? 2 minus x the whole square plus minus 5 minus 0 the whole square is equal to, now, PB. 2 minus 2 minus x the whole square plus 9 minus 0 the whole square. Okay. So 2 minus x the whole square plus minus 5 minus 0 means minus 5 the whole square is equal to, here minus and minus, here both the places minus is there, no? Minus you take outside, then what will happen? It will become minus when you are taking outside from here, along the square we are taking minus outside. Only minus not taking outside, because minus is inside the square, no, here. Therefore minus you are taking outside. What you are taking outside? Minus the whole square is taking outside. So what is minus the whole square? Plus. Okay, therefore what will come here? 2 plus x the whole square plus 9 square. Are you following? Okay. Next point, see. 2 minus x the whole square plus minus 5 the whole square is equal to 2 plus x the whole square plus 9 square. Okay, now square them. By which formula? A minus b the whole square. 4 minus 4x plus x square plus 25 plus 4. This is also 2 a plus b the whole square. 4 plus 4x plus x square plus 9 square is 81. So x square plus x square and 4 and 4 I cancel. You can see I underline the terms which are cancelled. X square cancelling, 4 and 4 cancelling. What is remaining here? Minus 4x plus 25. And here what is remaining? 4x plus 81. So this minus 4x I taken this here side. So it will become plus 4x. And this 81 taken this side, minus 81. So 25 minus 81 means minus 56 is equal to 8x. Calculation getting nicely. So x is equal to minus 56 by 8. Therefore the value of x is equal to how much got? Minus 7. So your question is to find out the point on the x-axis. So you got the point. So what is your required point? The value of x is equal to minus 7. Therefore your point is minus 7, 0. These type of sums are very, very important questions. So what is the point? Therefore the required point is minus 7, 0. Clear students? Okay. Now we will move to the next questions. Find the values of y for which the distance between the points P and Q is 10 units. Here directly the distance between the points is given as 10 units. Find the values of y for which the distance between which points are? Distance between the point P and Q. What are the coordinates of P? 2 minus 3 and coordinate of Q is 10. Y is given as 10. The meaning is that PQ is given as 10. Are you got clear? Distance between the points P and Q. What is the symbol we are giving? PQ. PQ how much given? 10. Okay. Now what we'll do? Here we apply the distance formula and find out the value of PQ. See here. PQ. PQ I am finding out here. So X2 Y2 X1 Y1 10. Minus 2 the whole square plus y minus minus 3 the whole square is equal to 10. So 10 minus 2 means 8. Y minus minus means y plus 3 the whole square is equal to 10. Now we want to remove the square root. Square root removing, you take the square on both sides. If you want to remove cube root, take the cube on both the sides. Just to opposite process too. Here we want to find out that we want to remove the square root. Its opposite process is square them. Square on both the sides. So here squaring root will cancel. Here squaring you will get 10 square. Okay. So 8 the whole square. 8 square plus y plus the whole square is equal to 10 square. So 8 square 64. And here y square plus 6y, a plus b the whole square formula only applying here. Okay. 3 square 9 is equal to 100. Therefore, y square plus 6y, 64 plus 9, 73. And this 100 I taken this side, minus 100 is equal to, you got minus 27. Now what you got? You got a quadratic equation. You got the quadratic equation. Y square minus 6y minus 27 equal to 0. So you factorize this term. Factorization all of you knowing now? Yes. Factorize it. See here. Plus 9 minus 3. How much coming? Plus 6 coming. And their product you are getting minus 27. So split the middle term. So splitting middle term. You want to get a 6y. How splitting? 9 minus 3. 9y minus 3y minus 27 equal to 0. Two terms take. All of you knowing? Okay. So what you got the factors? You got the factors as y plus 9 and y minus 3 are the two factors. Product of two factors is equal to 0. The meaning is that each factor is equal to 0. That means y plus 9 equal to 0 or y minus 3 equal to 0. Therefore the value of y is equal to minus 9 and the value of y you are getting as 3. Therefore you got the values of y is equal to minus 9 or 3. Okay. these are different sums. So that is why I am not giving homework. Same sums only we can give homework. Okay, next sum C. Question, listen this one. Question number 9C. 9, find the values of x. What is here question given? Q 0, the point Q. Q, the point Q, ordered by points Q, its coordinates are 0 and 1, is equidistant from which points? From P and R. Post question you want to make it clear. Some students are writing PR and PQ and PR taking and starting. You will not get the answer. Which point is equidistant? This Q is equidistant from P and R. The meaning is that QP is equal to QR. Such a way take. Okay. QP is equal to QR. The point Q is equidistant from P and R. Okay. Reverse anyway. You are understanding the question problem. Will erase. The words are properly read it and make it clear. Find the values of x. This you know now. Then after that, you will get the values of x. The values of x, you will get two values of x will get. So in both the cases, you want to find out the value of QR and PR. That is why I am explaining this one. Okay. So start. This you know, equidistant sum we already done. So knowing. If Q 0, so given points, right? Given points are P 5 minus 3, R X 6 is equidistant from which point Q. The meaning is that these two points are equidistant from which point Q. That is Q is equidistant from P and R. Clear? Therefore, what you will write? QP. Q is equidistant from P and R. The meaning is that QP is equal to QR. Clear? QP is equal to QR. Clear now, students? Okay. We can find out QP here. QP. So, 5 minus 0, the whole square plus minus 3 minus 1, the whole square. Properly, if you are listening, very easily getting. 5 minus 0 means 5 and here minus 4. So, you are getting it is 25 and here 16, root 41. Clear? And next one is QR, find out. QR is equal to what you are getting? Q and R. This one. So, x minus 0 the whole square plus 6 minus 1 the whole square. Okay. Root of x square plus 5 minus 6 minus 1 means 5. That is you are getting it is root of x square plus 25. Okay. Then what is you are given? What do you know? It is already given. Q is equidistant from P and R. The meaning is that QP is equal to QR. QP and QR are equal. Therefore, what we will do next? QP square is equal to QR square. So, QP is equal to how much? QR. So, root of 41 is equal to root of x square plus 25. Take the square on both the sides. So, 41 is equal to x square plus 25. From that, you will get the value of x. 41 minus 25 is equal to x square. That is, x square is equal to 16. Therefore, the value of x will be plus or minus 4. Plus 4 also possible, minus 4 also possible. Because it is coordinate geometry, the coordinates can be plus or minus anything possible. Therefore, both the values we want to accept. X is equal to plus 4 also possible. X is equal to minus 4 also possible. Therefore, what is the coordinates of R? Therefore, the coordinates of R is how much given? Coordinates of R is how much? 4, 6 or minus 4, 6. So, the value of X, R is given as X, 6. X you found out. The value of X can be 4 possible. X can be minus 4 also possible. So, if R is equal to 4, 6, you find out PR and QR. If R is equal to minus 4, 6, you find out PR and QR. That is your question. So, you got the values of x. Values of x which you got? Plus 4 got and minus 4 got. In both the cases, you want to find out the value of PR and QR. That is your question. See here. Here I found out PR and QR. Both I found out. Now, see here. PR got. P. Coordinates, I simply here written PR for your understanding. P and R. This is P. P how much? 5 minus 3. R is how much? 4, 6. See here. P, R. So 4 minus 5 the whole square. 4 minus 5 the whole square plus 6 minus minus 3 the whole square. So minus 1 the whole square plus 9 square. So how much got? A root of 82. Q R also find out. Q R is the here. Q is here. 4 minus 0 the whole square plus 6 minus 6 minus 1 the whole square. So here got. Okay, QR and PR both found out now. Same way, if R is minus 4, again you find out the value of PR and QR. See here. PR found out here. Okay. Minus 4 minus 5 the whole square plus 6 minus minus 3 the whole square. That means minus 9 the whole square plus 6 minus minus 3, which it will become 6 plus 3, that is 9. So 9 plus 9, how much coming? 81 plus 81. So what you will get it? 2 times 81. That is root of 81 is 9. So what you got? 9 root 2. And same way QR also find out. Q and R knowing, find out. Okay. What you got it is 41. So values of value of QR in both the case, what you got? A 41, root 41 only. In here, in the case of x minus 4, in the case of x plus 4, in both the cases you got the value of QR is 41 only, but the values of PR are different. One place you got root of 82, another place you got a root of 9 root. Clear? So this is your question. So equidistant given, then we found out the value of x in both the x. Then for each value of x, we have to find out the value of PR and QR. Okay, clear? Okay, one more sum is there, the last sum. Find a relation between x and y such that the point xy is equidistant from the point 3, 6 and minus 3, minus 4. Here you want to find out the relation between. So you will get an equation only. Relation between them. So equidistant sums you knowing now. So clearly knowing. So the finally what you will get, you will get the relation between x and y will get. Okay. See here. The point PXY. Point PXY is equidistant from which points? A 3, 6 and B minus 3, 4. Okay, understood now? First we given the names. Only I given the names. This point I given a name as P and this point I given the name A and this point I given the name as B. So P is equidistant from A and B. The meaning is that PA and PB are equal. Clear? So see, PA and PB are equal. Here I separate them for your understanding. Okay. PA, see here, 3 minus x the whole square plus 6 minus y the whole square, expand them, a minus b the whole square apply, 9 minus 6x plus x square, here 36 minus 12y plus y square, okay, following, x square plus y square minus 6x minus 12y for 36 plus 9, 45, okay, this type of sums easily understanding type of sums only. No need of more and more explanation. Here also see. PB found out. See here. And now what I written? PA and PB already equal given in the question. So I written in the place of PA value given. In the place of PB I written the values. Then what we have done? Squaring on both the sides. Squaring on both the sides, what will happen? The square root will vanish. Okay. So you are getting in this way terms, which terms common? X square plus y square, x square plus y square in both the places common coming, it will cancel. Remaining terms you arrange on one side. Minus 6x, minus 12y, plus 4y. And these terms bring this sign, so sign will change. Minus 6x plus 8y, minus 25 equal to 0. Okay. Now, add the terms. So minus 6x minus 6x, how much will come? Minus 12x, minus 12y plus 8y minus 4y plus 45 minus 25 plus 20. You got the equation now? Now, which is common throughout the equation? If you are closely watching, you can see minus 4 is common. So throughout divide by minus 4, dividing throughout by minus and multiplying throughout by minus, sign will change. So here what will come? Sign will become plus. Here also sign will become plus, and here also sign will become minus. Now 4 divide 4 dividing, what will get here? 3x, and here y, and here minus 5. So you got the relation 3x plus y minus 5 is equal to 0, which is the required relation between x and y. Your question is that find x and y, not asked in the question. Find a relation between x and y. Find a relation between x and y means always you will get in the form of an equation only. Okay, x and y separate not possible to find out here. So what is the relation you got? The value of x is equal to, sorry, the relation between x and y you got as 3x plus y minus 5 equal to 0. Okay students, the exercise 7.1 completed. So next video we will come with the derivation of different formulas. Okay, bye.